104.5 XLO live in the Clinton Savings Bank studio. We want to welcome friend of the program, Gina Gardner, to us. Gina is the nurse manager of the pediatric unit and pediatric intensive care unit at UMass. Good morning, Gina. How are you today?
Good morning, Frank. Thank you so much for having me.
Well, normally we're talking to you, and it's a cheery thing, and it's around Christmas, but we've got something we need to talk about today because there's a problem out there that's a related problem to COVID that a lot of people aren't aware of. What's going on that you've noticed?
So, just so you're aware, last month our admissions for pediatric behavioral health needs, including suicide attempts, intentional overdoses, and eating disorders, tripled. That's an increase of 180%. Usually we see about 46 kids, and in October we saw 139. This is a crisis. The stress of COVID affects all of us, but what's happening to our kids? We have some problems. Social media, screen time, some very good messages, but also there's some really bad messages right now.
Now, when you say you had an increase in the psychiatric, you're talking about also an increase in attempted suicide, right?
Absolutely. It is overwhelming. These kids are not kidding. It's no joke. They are depressed. They are just feeling really, really bad, and we need to do something about it.
We absolutely do. Gina, as parents, and I have two teenagers, what are some warning signs that parents can look out for? Because I try to check in on my boys every day and just say, how are you doing?
Yeah, the key is not just how are you doing. How are you really doing? Not just what's going on in school, what's going on with your friends. How are you doing? How are you doing emotionally? How are you doing physically? This isn't an easy conversation, right? This can be really uncomfortable. A lot of people think, if I bring up depression or suicide to my kid, I'm planting that seed. And that's not true. The evidence is that a conversation about suicide and depression with your child will lead to a productive discussion, and the child will feel less isolated. You know how you want to be the perfect family. You don't want anybody to think that your kid's not doing well. Those days are out the window. We need to be able to have that discussion with your child.
What are the warning signs that parents should look for?
You know, looking at really a lot of screen time. What are they doing on that computer? How much TikTok is on there? There's some very bad things on TikTok right now. Teaching you how to lose weight quickly or how you can end your life, right? These things are out there for days before they get pulled down. Know what they're looking at. Know what they're watching. Look for a weight loss. Some kids we're seeing, they've lost 40 pounds in a matter of 8 weeks. Ask the questions. Notice what they're eating. Notice if they're restricting themselves. More bathroom time, right? What's going on? Ask the questions.
Well, Gina, you know, Frank and I talk about just as adults how hard this is to navigate. So you can only imagine teenagers and young adults trying to do this as well.
We are overwhelmed with the number of kids in the hospital right now. And these are the ones we see. We're not seeing everything going on at home. So we need our parents to have these conversations with their children. We need your help before it gets to this point.
Well, Gina, hopefully this conversation will help, and we want to thank you for coming on and talking to us, and we'll look forward to seeing you soon.
Thank you so much, you guys. I hope to see you real soon.
All right. Bye, Gina.
Thanks,
thank
Gina.
You.
Bye-bye.